Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So it's the first of the month, and you know what that means. It's time for another Amazon haul, and I bought so many different things, but I've changed up the format and I've decided to do things a little differently. So usually I open the boxes in front of you guys. This time I already opened all of the boxes. There are two boxes in front of me right now. They are packed to the brim. So I thought that this way is sort of better because I've already tried some of these things now. I can give you guys like a genuine opinion after experiencing it myself and just seeing what I like, what I don't like. Like, I haven't tried everything, but a lot of these things I've already used. Since this time's haul is so large, I've decided to split it into two. So in today's video, it's just going to be all edibles, like pantry food related items, some snacks, some soft drinks, as well as some kitchen stuff that you would cook with. In the second part of this video, which you guys will see in 2 days time, I have put everything else which is not food related. So there is cleaning supplies, like kitchen stuff, bathroom stuff and stuff like that also. So if you can watch that video, this is going to come out like 2 days after this. If you're watching this later, it might already be out. Let's just get into the video. We have a lot to cover. Because I just tied up my hair because it's really hot. I'm going to delve into the box on my left right now, which I've roughly put everything snack related. So let's get started. The first thing that I have is the Act 2 Cheese Bakes combo. I've been buying this for many months, so it's definitely a repurchase like for me. This is a buy one get one free combo. So these are really nice and crunchy and cheesy and light. They're something like Cheetos in a way, and they're really good for snack time. I enjoy them. So I have here with me, I think, 3 buy one get one free packs, but that's because I've already eaten 2 or 3 packs. We like this quite a lot. Here I have some juice, or this would be like a drink you could say, from Paperboat brand. This is the Jaljeera flavored drink. Jaljeera is just like a mixture of different things like jeera, and it's supposed to be cooling and digestive, and it's really refreshing during hot summer days. I really enjoy having this in the daytime because it's just light and nice. This was a pack of 6. I already drank one, which is why it's opened, and there are 5. The next thing is this really random thing that my mother enjoys. It's called Paspas, and it is a mouth freshener. It's like a little bit of a candy, a little bit of a digestive. She used to really like this a few years ago. I saw it on Amazon. I just bought it for her on a whim. She still likes it very much. Here I've got 2 dabbas of it. I also kept this to show you guys. There are 2 empty dabbas which is already finished. I'm mad after this, like totally mad. This is available in like a couple of different flavors, but she only likes the hot pink one. It's called Meetha Magic, which basically means sweet magic. The other one is Pudina. It's a mint one. I don't think she likes it. I don't think anybody likes it. I don't know why they make it, but this pink one is really good. I've not tried it, but it has my mother's seal of approval, so I'm sure it's nice. Next, I have some biscuits that if you watched my previous haul also, you will have seen these. Just tried the Bonvita biscuits tiffin packs, and I really liked it. Like, it's sweet, but it's not over the top. And it was tasting nice. It had this chocolatiness to it, and it's like a solid form of the Bonvita drink one day. And it tastes really good with tea, at least I think so. I bought this big pack. So there are 9 tiffin packs in each packet, and I have 5 of these like boxes or whatever you want to call it. I know this is going to last a very long time, but this is a really good snack at any time of the day also. And these tiffin packs can easily be kept in your bag also and carried with you wherever you're going. I really like this. I'm still wondering why I bought like so much, but I think we can finish it. Next, I have a breakfast cereal. I'm not so much of a cornflake person usually. A few years ago, I first tried the Kellogg's strawberry cornflakes, and I really like them because they're so tasty and they're crunchy and they have this strawberry flavor, and it actually makes the milk also like into strawberry milk. So when you have like the milk and cornflakes, and it's really yummy, and it is a little sweet, but again, I didn't find it too sweet. I don't like stuff that's very sugary, but this got the balance right. And then for for 1 or 2 years, I feel like this disappeared, like, from India. I couldn't find it anywhere. I don't know if it was available. So I saw it available again. I just, like, quickly picked up two of these because during the hot mornings, if you have some cornflakes or any cereal really with chilled milk, it's super refreshing. Like, I don't like having toast or poa or anything hot, but then this really cools me down and makes me feel nice. Oh, look, I found another one of these packets. I already showed it to you guys. Did not realize there was another one hiding inside the box. So I picked up one of this Pillsbury cookie cake. I don't know what this is and I've never tried it before. It's supposed to be a little bit crunchy like a cookie, a little bit soft like a cake. It was just on offer on Amazon and I thought, why not try it? Purchased two crushes from Macro. One is Kokum Crush, and if you're wondering about what Kokum is, it's I would say a fruit that's available a lot, like, in the Konkan coastal region of, like, Maharashtra and even Goa, and it's also known as Indian mangosteen. Second one is Pink Guava Crush. These are both really good summer coolers, and crush means that it's like a thick concentrate with sugar. You can mix this with chilled water, like they're recommending. This one says chilled water, this one says still or aerated water. I love having this with soda sometimes. The only downside I find with Mapro's drinks are they are on the sweet side. They put too much of sugar in them, like, some is necessary, they put a little extra, but otherwise their quality is good and they're really affordable. There's a huge variety. And now I tried another concentrate of Kokum from this brand called Keynote. So the Keynote brand one was more expensive than Mapro, like, it costed more and you get a much smaller size. But having actually tried this, I can tell you guys honestly that I am absolutely obsessed with it, and this is, like, one of my favorite little discoveries. This is my first bottle. It's almost done and it's really, really nice quality. This is not just Kokum, but it's enhanced with cumin or jeera. So it really just brings a little extra flavor, and jeera's a digestive, it's cooling, and it's really nice. You can have this with water or soda. I've tried both. It's not too sweet. Of course, there is sugar in it because Kokum is a sour fruit, so you do need to put sugar. But this is, like, just the right amount, and this is really good. But I enjoy the Kokum one and I recommend it wholeheartedly. The next thing that I bought is not really for me, sort of for my parents. It is this Ensure nutritional drink that I think they recommend for people like above the age of 40 or something. It has lower sugar and it just has, like, all the extra nutrition that you would need as you age and all. It helps build bones, muscle, provide energy, stuff like that. And my parents have this regularly. So they have this in two flavors, vanilla and chocolate. And I asked my mother, of course she likes the chocolate better. Who doesn't like chocolate better? So this is the 400 gram size of chocolate. I'm kind of tempted to try it out. I think I should, like, at least one day I should also taste this. I don't know how it tastes, but it gets good reviews. The next thing I have is another little sweet from Paperboat brand that I have already shown probably in two hauls at least. It's their family pack of Ampappad. Ampappad is like a mango based soft candy. This has 3 units. It looks like 2 because 2 of them are stuck here. It's a roadside snack that's available in Mumbai during fairs and stuff like Bandra Fair. But I mentioned before that it's always sold under unhygienic conditions on the road. So to get it from a brand like this where it's hygienically packed and it's much safer and cleaner makes me feel good. Next are some biscuits. These are Sunfeast Farm Light biscuits with protein, and it has no maida and it's made from atta. It has, like, wheat and gram and stuff. Sometimes you just want a healthy snack. The next thing I have is Sunfeast Mom Magic chocolate chip biscuits. I really like chocolate chip biscuits or cookies, whatever you call them, but I don't think I've tried this particular brand or variant. I usually go for hide and seek, which I like. The packaging look good, there's, like, chunks of chocolate. It says Mom Magic, so I was like, why not try it? But I have not tasted it yet. So you get 6 individually packed biscuits inside, which is really nice if you just want to take one somewhere. This is what the cookie looks like. They always make it look a little bit nicer on the box. That's just how these things work. It's really nice. Got a lot of crunch in it. And it's got that sweet flavor with a little hint of like saltiness, which I love. Probably not the healthiest, but tasty as a treat. And since it's individually packed, you can just have like one at a time and not overdo it. The next biscuit I have is Sunfeast Murray Light. I don't think this biscuit needs any explanation. It's just a classic. Again, that's really good at tea time. I like having it dry, but my mother likes dipping it in tea. I like my biscuits to always have some crunch. So let me know how you guys like having Murray biscuits, or do you like it at all? I think most people do, right? So I always buy a lot of Murray biscuits. This time I only bought one packet because I think we already have some at home. I bought a lot of newly launched snacks from Paper Boat. This was my first time buying them, and they're available in like packs of three. I think I overdid it, but they're pretty nice. So they've come out with some new snacks. They have this snack called Shankar Para. Then they have this other snack called Namak Para. And finally, they have the third one called Gur Para. So this is a very similar kind of Shakar Para, okay. But we call it Shankar Pal sometimes. This one has sugar in it. Shakar literally means sugar. So it's this, what would you describe it like? Little bits of dough, eh? Yeah, it's a traditional Indian farsan. This is a sweet one, so that's why it's called Shakar. I bought quite a lot of it. The next one is called Namak Para, because namak literally means salt. So this is like the salty, savory sort of version of the very same snack. The third one is called Gur Para, which is also sweet, but instead of Shakar, which is sugar, it has jaggery in it. So the taste is distinctive, it's a little different, and it's got that typical jaggery flavor and smell. And it reminds you of snacks that you only like get in villages. Like when we go to Goa and stuff, we get snacks that have jaggery in them. I don't find these kind of snacks like readily available in the cities. Have a lightness to them, but they're also kind of heavy, if that makes sense. Like they're not really heavy, but they're filling. I find that I never overeat too much of the snack because I get full really easily with it. Even though I'd not tasted these before, I saw that the reviews were really good. So I was like, why not? I think my whole family has enjoyed it. If you ask me my favorite, I like the namak one best because I tend to prefer savory snacks. Finally, few things in this box we've reached, but there's actually still a lot more to cover. I've got two vanilla flavored Bowly moon pills in here. These are also repurchases. I buy these all the time and I'm very obsessed with them. These are not the only Bowly moon pills in the haul, but these are the two that I picked up loose from pantry because I also bought some boxes. We have some chips from one of my favorite brands, Pringles of course. My favorite flavor of theirs is the sour cream and onion, and so I picked up three of the sour cream and onion chips. These are really nice. They are a little more expensive than Lay's or anything like that, but they're really crunchy, the texture is good, and you get a lot inside this dabba. And I never finish these in one sitting. One box will last me for like a couple of days, even if I'm sharing it. And it's really good. And I picked up another one of this Pringles in a different flavor called Zingy Tomato. Don't think I've tasted Zingy Tomato before, or did I try it last month? I'm not sure. Don't know if I like it as much as sour cream and onion, but I figured that it made sense to get a little bit of variety. Now we're on to the next box, and the first thing I'm going to show you guys is the tea that I bought. We drink a lot of tea at home, especially my dad. He's the original tea drinker, but he likes it really simple. He just likes like regular black tea with milk, and he doesn't even have sugar. We prefer masala chai. So I think I bought a little too much this month. Maybe I won't buy next month because there's a lot. This is a brand that my mom used to usually buy. It's the Taj Mahal tea bags. And this is the brand that I've been buying more recently, and my mother told me she actually prefers this brand now. This is Typhoo. It's the classic Assam chai. So I actually bought four of these Typhoo tea bags. the Taj Mahal one as well as the Typhoo one, you get 100 in a box. So it's basically the same size of box. But what my mother liked about the Typhoo one packaging wise is that, so there are like four separate packets inside of 25 tea bags each, like this. Whereas in the Taj Mahal one, it's just like 100 tea bags all inside one packet, so there's no separation. And this just keeps things fresh a little bit longer, so you can only open one packet at a time. And it's a small little design feature that makes this my mother's preferred brand. So now I don't think I'm going to buy Taj Mahal. I'm going to buy the Typhoo one. The taste is also really good. If you like your black tea very strong, you probably should not get this because it's a little light. Like, or you'll need to have two tea bags. But my dad is not particular about it being strong since he has so many in a day. So we like Typhoo. And this is what we put in our tea as like the dairy creamer. This is Nestle's everyday milk powder or dairy creamer. So sometimes we'll use like packaged carton milk, sometimes we'll use milk powder. This gives the tea a really good taste and like a texture. And it's already got some sweetness in it. So if you're adding sugar, you need to adjust. Like when you're adding milk powder, you can add less sugar because it's got a little bit of sugar content already. Very tasty, and I've had a habit of eating spoonfuls of these plain since I was a little kid. I still do it. Here's a snack that I think I forgot to show you guys from the first box. This is two yum veggie sticks, a roasted garlic flavor. I tasted some of the other variants of two yum. I didn't like it very much. I know there are a lot of ads with Virat Kohli on TV right now. The other one that I tried, like the cheesy one, was not my favorite. It's supposed to be healthy. This is a roasted garlic flavor, and I love garlic, so I said let me give this different flavor a try and see if I like that better. Another milk powder, four in total. Here I have three small packets of till, also known as sesame. This is nylon till. When I went to buy sesame online, I realized there are many different, like there are white till and black till, and they're just different variants. So I picked this up. Sesame is really healthy, so I intend to dry roast all of these. Maybe even in a pan, you can easily sort of toast them and put them in a jar, and then you can use it on like vegetables. You can use it if you're doing a stir fry. A lot of salads taste yummy with it. So it gives you that little extra texture, like it's crunchy. And you're also getting like the health benefits and stuff. Now another tea related item. I mean, we use this for a lot of things, but most of our sugar is consumed in tea only. It's the Madhur Pure and Hygienic Sugar. And I bought 3 1-kilo packs of this sugar. You can get this in a 5 kg pack too if your consumption is really high. But since we don't have that much, I buy the 1 kg to keep it fresh. And a local like grocery shop also sells this, but they sell it at full price, and on Amazon I get it cheaper and I get it delivered home. So I buy these every month, and many of you guys told me that you buy it as well. So this month I was having a craving for like some really Indian pickles, and I picked some up. First I picked up this sachet pack of Mother's Recipe garlic pickle. I've never tried this before, and as you can see, I haven't opened it yet. People were saying it's good, it's pungent, but it's good, so I'm looking forward to trying it out. Next I picked up two pickles from this brand called Shelly's. The mango chili pickle and the Indian olive chutney. The Indian olive chutney especially is supposed to be a traditional Bengali recipe called Jalpai. I really like this look. So they're available in two sizes, but I bought the small size of each because it was the first time I was trying it. The olive one is so good. It's mostly sweet, it's a little spicy, and it tastes really nice. I will be repurchasing this in the big size. I've not tried the mango chili pickle, but I'm sure I'll try it soon. And the next, I bought one seasoning powder from this brand called Urban Platter. This is supposed to be the all natural and premium Cajun spice seasoning. So you can use this as a seasoning like on top of your dishes when it's done, or you can use it as a marinade powder. It's a blend of a lot of different flavors, okay? Chili powder, black pepper, mustard, cumin, parsley, oregano, salt, sugar, onion powder, garlic powder. Yesterday I made really good sweet potato fries. I sprinkled this on top with some salt. It's got salt in it, but a little bit. I added some more salt and it's really tasty. You can also use it to marinate meat. Anything where you're trying like Western dishes which require spice, like in Indian dishes, I use garam masala all the time. This is like a Western garam masala. Very tasty. The next thing I purchased for the first time is quinoa. Everyone knows what quinoa is. It's a superfood and it's like a grain. You can eat it in place of rice because it's supposed to be like a bit lighter and healthier and more nutritious. I've eaten quinoa in dishes, but I've never tried making it at home, and I was like, why haven't I tried it until now? So I bought a small packet from this brand called By Nature, and I'm going to give it a try really soon. And I think I'll be making quinoa more often because I've been cooking more often recently and enjoying it quite a bit. Next, I bought some garlic paste, some ginger paste, and some ginger garlic paste. So there are four different packs here, and yeah, they're all totally different. The first one is Mother's Recipe ginger garlic paste. The next one is Dabur Homemade ginger paste. The next one is Dabur Homemade ginger garlic paste. And finally, there's Dabur Homemade garlic paste. So ginger garlic paste is good if you're like happy with those proportions, but I bought separates also because sometimes I just want to put like only garlic paste, or I want to put extra garlic paste. That's why I bought them separately. Now I would definitely prefer the Dabur Homemade packaging to the Mother's Recipe packaging. This is just a sachet, but this actually has a little cap, so you can store it in the fridge easily. Like you can shut it, open it, like it's a little bottle almost. That way, I really like brands who take packaging a little more seriously. This is like a necessity in everyone's kitchen, unless you make your own. We don't have the patience to make our own, so we buy ready. And ginger garlic paste and all usually has extra salt also, so when you're cooking, you need to adjust that in your dishes and put less salt. Now for Mother's Recipe, I bought two papad packets. One is the Urad papad. This is what my mother usually always buys. She used to buy Lijjat, but I was like, let's try Mother's Recipe. The next one is the Madras appalam. This is the typical South Indian style papad. It's lighter and it's made of rice flour, while the Urad one is obviously made of Urad dal. So they're both really nice, and I picked them both up. I haven't tried either, but I'm sure Mother's Recipe will be good. More in my Indian cooking series, I bought Dabur Homemade tomato puree. This is like just a sort of a tomato paste that you can add into like any Indian dish. Say you just want to make it like into a curry consistency, or say you've run out of tomatoes at home. It's late and you can't go down and buy it, but you still want that tomato flavor. You can use this tomato puree and it's really good. I bought a few different masalas and powders from Tata Sampann brand. I purchased Tata Sampann before, they're good. The first one is coriander powder, also known as dhania, which is a masala that you need in a lot of Indian cooking. The next one is the Tata Sampann pakoda mix. My mother makes good pakodas. She uses mostly just besan, which is chane ka atta. This one is a blend apparently of besan and rice flour. And it also has spices already, so that's nice. But it turns out to be much more expensive than if you were to mix the besan and rice yourself. Still, I really wanted to try it once, which is why I bought it. Let's see how the pakodas turn out. We will be making the onion ones and the potato ones. Which ones do you guys prefer? The next thing from Tata Sampann is garam masala. I just mentioned that this is like my favorite Indian spice blend, and whenever I'm cooking, I use it very liberally. Whatever the recipe calls for, I just use more of it. Sometimes I'll just pour it and it's really good. So something that I liked about this box is there are 5 separate sachets inside, so it'll keep the masala fresh for longer. You can only open one packet at a time. I bought a bunch of Saffola's new active soups because I saw them available, and then I said, let me try these out. So I've actually bought 3 flavors, I think. There's creamy sweet corn, garden vegetables, and tangy tomato. So they only have vegetarian flavors, which I didn't love. I wish they had at least one token chicken flavor. I bought 3 of these because these didn't sound spicy. The other one sounded a little bit spicy and I'm avoiding spice. Bought like three of each flavor, I think. I picked up some pulses from this new brand that I saw called Vedaka, and it's actually Amazon's own brand. Just like Amazon Basics, they've come out with their own pulses brand. It's a lot cheaper than the competition and the quality is very, very good. I bought different pulses. These are all 500 gram packs. This one is Moong Chilka, which is broken moong bean. Masoor Dal, the orangey peach dal is Masoor Dal. This one is Toor Dal, the yellowish dal is Toor Dal. I am reminded of what I learned in second standard in school when we had to learn what all these dals were called. This one, what's this called in Hindi?
Kabuli Chana.
Kabuli Chana, yes. These are also known as garbanzo beans and they're also known as chickpeas. This is what you make hummus out of and you can make a ton of Indian dishes. Now, I'm gonna make dal soon. I've never made dal in my life. So I'm gonna try making dal fry and maybe I'll put it in a vlog. Final thing in this box, I picked up Coleman brand tartar sauce. Tartar sauce tastes really nice. It's like a typical British sauce that you can have, especially with fish, like fish fingers and all. It goes with a lot of different things. It's creamy but it's also sour and you can put it in burgers and stuff. And Coleman's is like one of the best brands. I also love their mustard. So I was very excited to see this and of course I bought it. I picked up one of this Tata rock salt. This is supposed to be better than the white iodized salt that you get. It's got like a pinkish hue and has natural minerals. We don't eat that much salt at home because it's not healthy to use too much of it and it's good if you can cut down. But still, I wanted to try this if it's healthier and the flavors are better. It's a little more expensive than the regular packets of salt you get, but this is still like pretty cheap if you go to see. You can also get this in like a salt grinder, but I figured that I'll use my own grinder and I might as well get the packet. It's a little coarser than your powdered salt, but it's still quite fine. One more soup from Knorr. I picked up the sweet corn chicken soup. This is sort of one of my favorites. It's got corn, which I love. It's got chicken, which I also like. Good soup. And now I picked up like an instant pasta dish from this brand called Gustora. This is supposed to be pasta in 5 minutes. It's a cream and cheese pasta. And apparently you can add milk to it to make it tastier. I like making pasta like from scratch the proper way, but that is quite a process. So sometimes if you just want a snack, like Maggie or something, maybe you could just have this and get ready very soon. And you can always add some vegetables or meat to it to make it more flavorful. So I only bought one because I'm going to taste it. If I like it, of course I'll purchase more. And now I bought 5 of what is essentially the same thing from Milkmaid. This is the ice cream kit. Milkmaid is sweetened condensed milk. So this is supposed to be everything that you need to make ice cream. It's got one tin or can of Milkmaid. And it's got one small packet of dairy cream. It's got one plastic dabba and it's got a recipe booklet. Now, I haven't tried making the ice cream itself, but I still bought 5 of these combos because it's really good value for money. And even if you don't want to make ice cream, the dabba can be used in the kitchen or the freezer or the fridge or anything. Cream can be used in a lot of recipes like pasta or anything. The Milkmaid also is really versatile and I've been thinking of making Vietnamese iced coffee or something, so you can easily use the Milkmaid for that. Or my mom makes a really good Milkmaid-based kulfi, so we can do that. And I might have gone like a little overboard. I'm really happy with this. 2 sort of food items that I have are more Bowli Moonfills. I already talked about how I'm obsessed with these. These are both chocolate flavor, but they're still different. The original Bowli Moonfill is actually not vegetarian by Indian standards because it contains egg. Now, I think it's very tasty, but I know that people who don't eat egg could not eat it. So they've actually released now a veg variant that does not have egg. I bought both of them so that I could taste them side by side. And I find a little difference, but the eggless one is still also good. And now more people can eat it. Like, we had a guest over yesterday who was vegetarian. We had to serve him like a snack. And I gave this to him. I think he really liked it. I don't know. So I like the idea that they've come out with a veg version. Because I've been recommending this for like months. But many people couldn't eat it, now they can. But if you eat egg, you can go with the egg version. Clear difference in the way that the individual packets are marked also. So this is the regular one, which has egg. And this is the new veg one. If you're trying to buy Bauli Moonfills for the first time, there are like four flavors, but I would recommend like the chocolate and vanilla are the better flavors because the cream is tastier. Strawberry and orange, I did not like as much. So that's all for the food section of this haul. And come back soon, you guys, because I'm going to show you all of the non-food related items. I hope you enjoyed this. I know it ran really long, but I felt like I showed you guys a lot and gave you information. Today's super value day, so if you shop, you get like special offers and stuff on Amazon. That's why I put out my videos today. Super value day is the first 3 dates of every month. If you'd like to buy any of the things I show you guys, just click show more below and check everything out. Happy shopping! If you enjoyed this video, press that red subscribe button and I'll see you guys later. Bye!